Bien, y termino con dos comentarios
okay. Now I will conclude with two brief comments. The first is that in a market economy, the purchasing power of the monetary unit is in a constant state of flux, and variations can originate on the monetary side or on the real side. Variations in purchasing power originate on the real side when they result from increases or decreases in the supply of goods and services. If there is a poor crop, the price of wheat rises, and therefore the purchasing power of the monetary unit in terms of wheat falls. But the most distorting variations in purchasing power are those which originate on the monetary side. That is, when the quantity of money in circulation increases or decreases. This gives me the opportunity to introduce two concepts, the concept of inflation and the concept of deflation. Inflation refers to an increase in the quantity of money offered in the market, and, other things being equal, this increase gives rise to a decrease in purchasing power. Notice I say, other things being equal. Deflation is the opposite. Deflation refers to a decrease in the quantity of money offered in the market, and, other things being equal, this decrease gives rise to an increase in purchasing power, that is, a drop in prices. In a market economy, the purchasing power of money is in a constant state of flux, but changes are gradual in every sense. They are small and easily predictable. The popular notions of inflation and deflation have to do with big changes that always have a monetary origin. It is just that citizens and politicians have confused the symptoms with the cause, and they call an increase in prices inflation, which is an error. Scientifically speaking, inflation is not an increase in prices, but an increase in the quantity of money, which, other things being equal, does lead to a decrease in purchasing power. That is, a rise in prices, but not always. Why do politicians like citizens to believe inflation consists of a rise in prices? Very simple. When the CPI is compiled and people remark, inflation has gone up a lot this month, 2%, what are they saying on TV? Do you know who is to blame? Chickens, movie theaters. Those scumbags have raised the price of chicken and potatoes. They're crooks. And citizens all say to themselves, damn, it's true. Those scumbag poultrymen, taxi drivers and theatre owners, they're raising prices. This is a great advantage to politicians because, in error, the wrath of the people is directed against scapegoats that have nothing to do with the problem. If we preserved the scientific concept of inflation, we would see that inflation is an increase in the quantity of money. And who is responsible for increases in the quantity of money nowadays? Monetary authorities and governments. They are solely responsible for decreases in the purchasing power of the monetary unit. They simply hide their responsibility from citizens by debasing or corrupting the concept of inflation, redefining it as an increase in prices, and blaming alleged agents who have nothing to do with the process, chicken producers, potato producers, etc. I say that, other things being equal, an increase in the quantity of money pushes up prices, but, other things being equal, because an increase in the quantity of money does not necessarily lead to a rise in prices. Imagine that an increase in the quantity of money coincides with a large simultaneous increase in the real productivity of goods and services. One effect offsets the other, and prices do not rise. And that is precisely what happened in the cycle that concluded a few years ago and lasted 15 years. There was tremendous inflation in terms of growth in the money supply. Each year, it grew by between 7 and 10%. And nevertheless, prices did not rise. Why? Due to entrepreneurial innovations, the internet, etc., real productivity also grew by 7 or 10%, and prices remained more or less stable. Citizens were delighted and thought a virtuous cycle had been found. And yet, the productive structure was undergoing a process of distortion like the one we just illustrated with this great simulation game. And the foundations were laid for the most severe financial crisis and economic recession to hit since the Second World War. Then there was the famous oil crisis of the 1970s. Oil producers are at fault. They are raising prices. No. If it had been a true oil crisis without inflation, an increase in the quantity of money, we would have managed to buy the same amount of oil at higher prices only if we had tightened our belts and bought less of other goods. We would have seen a sharp rise in the price of oil and a fall in the price of the goods we had given up so we could keep buying energy. What we saw was a huge increase in the price of all goods and a much more than proportional increase in the price of oil. When all prices rise to one extent or another, that indicates a dramatic increase in the quantity of money in the system, a change on the monetary side, and the responsibility rests with monetary authorities and governments. Now, central bankers are blaming the crisis on speculators, bankers and entrepreneurs, when they themselves, central bankers and governments, are the only ones responsible. But they specialize in shifting blame onto innocent parties and directing the people's wrath towards others who simply acted as instruments of their misguided policies.